I have iced it. Sup?
Okay, so today I took the quite frankly elevation blend and I've iced it. So I brewed a pot of it last night and cooled it down and put it in the fridge over the course of the evening, because it is a gorgeous day. And I knew that we were going to be safely into iced coffee territory soon. So that's where we are right now, iced coffee territory. I'll still have a hot cup. I'll still have nice piping hot cups of coffee, but tis the season for me to ice this bad boy down. Get that raw cow dairy. What's up, everybody? What's going on, Didn't? What's up, Stephanie? Long time no see. Top of the morning, Linnea. Top of the morning to you. Top of the morning to you. I got a fresh shaved dome as of last night. Although I must admit, I couldn't take a shower. They did some work in the bathroom over the weekend, and for some reason, the water wasn't draining. So they got to come by today and see what the hell's clogged. It's certainly not me. I didn't clog the bathroom shower drain. It's been a long, long time since I've had enough hair to clog a bathroom drain. So see what the hell's going on there. So I don't feel quite as fresh. Vinegar and baking soda will clear it up. Well, maybe I'll try that. Just keeping at work here in Hamilton, Scotland, new home of no free speech. Chris, I would mourn your loss, but we're not that far behind. Let's see. Alrighty. This is my coffee of the day. I'm gonna move. So how you guys doing? Anybody around for book club last night? How incredible book club is? I gotta say, I'll say it again, over and over again. Some people out there, they've got their mug clubs and stuff like that. If there's anything, any reason to sign up as a sponsor, it's to just get access to the book clubs. Even if you're just doing the audiobooks, just be there for the sessions. Book clubs, and also I'm gonna start streaming band practices for monthly sponsors too. So you'll get that. But still, book club was just invigorating. Thank you, Mel. It was a good one. Is this pre or post raw eggs? This is pre. I'm glad you brought that up, because last night I plotted out what I'm going to eat. My point, I have to get to 180 grams of protein a day. I have to lock into that. So what I figured, when I break my fast, maybe around 11 o'clock or so, I woke up, I had my salt water, that was about an hour ago, so now we're on with this. I brought Aurora to the deli and the bakery. Oh, she's such a treat to shop with. And I'm thinking 8 eggs. I've been doing about 7 eggs, but I think I'm gonna up it to 8 eggs. 8 eggs a shot. The way I prepare it is 8 eggs, a little bit of half and half, a little bit of vanilla, and on select days, I'll put a medium banana in there and blend it together and just take that whole damn thing down. That's 48. That's 48 grams of protein right there in one shot. And I've been having that 7 to 8 eggs for a while now, but I think if I just level it off at 48, then around a couple hours later, crack open a can of tuna fish or chicken salad, I can get at least one can of tuna fish. The line caught tuna in there, that's the that's 20 grams a can. That'll get me to 68 grams. Now, add the cheeses, and there's a couple of things. The cottage cheese, I get the double cream cottage cheese, so I can get that to about 25 grams. There's 48. There's another 45. That's just that added to the other 48. We're flirting with 100. Flirting with 100 right there. I got the beef liver capsules for around 100 grams. And then there's the steak at night. Then there's the steak. I think a half pound ribeye, which is about $17, is, can someone do the calculations on a half a pound? Wait, what's a pound of beef? We'll just do a pound of beef. One pound ribeye. So, shit. 1 pound. I don't know, 108 grams? 1 pound of steak is about 95, 108, this says for a ribeye, it says 108 grams of protein. That's great, because I've got a half a pound in there. That's still about 50. That'll get me to about 160 grams, but if I can get, wow. Damn. Okay. That's when we'll really start seeing the shred happening. Never go under 2 pounds. Well, in a couple of years, I'll be able to cook 2 pounds at a time, because Aurora eats the steak with me. I got her eating steak and bacon early, and she likes it now. Similar diet, Katie. Well, I don't know. You probably have a lower goal. Bunch of ground beef and eggs, cheap and easy. It is, Jack. It is, and that's what I just want to do. I want to get. That's why I'm saying the biggest thing for me is starting it off. I guess I should have held off with this coffee, and I should have just done the eggs with you. We should have slunked the eggs together. What's going on, Patrick in Alaska? Love steak, especially marinated steak tips. The tips are nice. I gain weight if I eat that much meat. Not sure why. Yeah, that wouldn't be it. Unless, of course, you're not, you know, that wouldn't be it. Unless you are in a, you know, there are calories attached to everything, no matter how lean it is. So the real thing is, are you in a caloric deficit? That's just simple thermodynamics. So you want to eat one. So I want to eat about 180 grams of protein, because I want to be around 185. I want to get down to about 185. I'm around, still hovering around like 197. You ever told me I'd be near 200 pounds. So, but I want to eat for that 180, 185 area of a protein, because that's the body I want to support. That's the weight I want to support. I think it'll be easy if I just start drinking most of it. You know, you sit down and to make 8 eggs and eat it. Ugh, that sounds so tiring. That sounds very, very tiring. So I'm just gonna drink them. Sup, Reby? Hey. So those of you who are sponsors of the show, and you are hanging with us on Sunday afternoons, I told you a little something on Sunday, a concept I'm developing. It doesn't take that much development. It's an idea. I don't know when to do it, but I think tonight, maybe not tonight, but next Tuesday might be the first Rude Tuesday. And because I have a lot of leftover things to do tonight. I got a couple of things that came in about Jerome, Arizona. I got a couple of things that came in from that when we were doing weird travel stories. So I want to do that tonight and a few other things. I got to check with the band to make sure that we're all getting together and practicing. So that's that. Rude Tuesday. Rude Tuesday. You know what that is? People say I'm too nice. Well, at least one Tuesday a month, I'm gonna be very rude. I tried a liquid diet. I'm still hungover. Yeah, only fluids, the doctor said. One meal a day. 40 years old, 5'10", 175, eat a pound of lean meat. Yeah, listen, Uncle Sam, one meal a day, that works great for a lot of people. It would probably work great for me if you eat just a really hearty meal. You know, a pound of beef, mixed it in with a little bit of eggs or something else, whatever. Jay, I think, only eats one meal a day. One main meal a day in between his fasts and all that stuff. So there's been, who is it? There's a couple of really well-known bodybuilders that only did the one meal a day too. Giant meals. One meal a day. So, Frank, have you tried beefalo? Beefalo, no. What is it? Is it like a mixture of buffalo and bison and beef? Love the podcast, Frank, but looks like, but Frank, I love this podcast, but Frank looks New York as fuck. Okay, I'll work on that. I drink unflavored gelatin, and collagen in my coffee. Yeah, I used to do the collagen. Not the collagen. Yeah, the collagen protein. Like this breaks my fast essentially because I got the raw dairy creamer in here. You want to talk about MCT? Want to talk about high fats? Got more of this coming in. But what's that? Brazilian congressman? What? I don't know. But I'm also trying to eat early too. I don't want to eat late anymore. I want to eat between 10 and before. I want to have my last meal of the day before I go to the studio. And then just the rest of the night can be San Pellegrino. Yeah, that's what I'm hoping, Katie. Sleeping better. No weird dreams. I bet you any money the things that I eat before bed. Well, I don't eat and then jump right into bed, but still, if I eat at 10 and I go to sleep at 12:30, bet you any money has an impact on my dreams. Where do you get your raw dairy? I get it from Meadow Ridge Farm in Pennsylvania. They deliver all across this whole region. I think they deliver from, I think, like Virginia up or something like that. Meadow Ridge Farm. You pay like $30, a one-time $30 lifetime membership fee, and that gets you approved for delivery, and they give you your pickup spots, and it's like a every 2 weeks delivery. At least for us over here. Started eating bread again, gained 10 pounds, not doing that anymore. I love bread, but it's just, I leave it for the weekends. I leave most of my bread eating for the weekends. That's it. Well, sourdough is pretty good. Like my my sister-in-law, hold on. This, my sister-in-law just made this loaf for us the other day. Most of our bread comes from her. It's all sourdough. So she's been keeping this, what do they call it again? She's kept this this lineage, this sourdough lineage, the yeast. She's kept this alive and going for almost 2 years now. And most of our bread comes from her. And even Jay said, if you're going to eat bread, eat something that's fermented, like sourdough. So the sour, the more sour, the better. I always love sourdough. So when Jay told me that sourdough bread was actually, you know, better than most, I said, yes. Starter. Yes, the sourdough starter. The sourdough starter, that's what they call it. Frank, being a drummer like myself, have you ever measured how much weight you lose after a practice or a gig? No. That's the short answer. No, I've never weighed myself before or after a gig, but it is all water weight. That's just a lot of water weight that's lost. There are so many times, I mean, especially in New York City, some of those smaller clubs, heat stroke, like you're on, especially for me, in the back, playing the kind of music we used to play, especially when we were really like, you know, it was very fast and heavy. There are some times that I kind of blacked out. And I kept playing, I never fell off the set, but I kind of went unconscious. And there was just so much drain. So much drain. You lose so much water. So I don't know if it would have showed up on a scale, but it definitely takes it out of you depending on what you're playing and how you're playing it. And for how long. Let's see. Up, 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 over the process. Let's see, starter or mother? Gotcha. How tall are you? 5'11". 5'11". I never broke 6 feet. Never broke 6 feet. I wondered. I was always like, is it going to happen? Nope. Did not happen. You got good bagels out there? Absolutely. Yes. A lot of good bagels. There, actually, there's this one place. There's this bagel place in Greenwich that is so exclusive. It's so exclusive that you have to do special orders, and you have to you're given the time to come in and pick it up. And I told Lauren, I want to try some of this because my sister-in-law keeps going on and on about it. All the different types of things that they work into. It's pretty good. That's what I hear. But all the places I do know personally are great too. Like we got this place called Lenny's. They're pretty good. There's the Bagel Emporium. What else? I don't know. Oh, wait. Hand-rolled bagels. Hand-rolled bagels is awesome. They're flagels. Oh! They make these flagels, mini flagels. They make the mini flagels. These things, you're like, oh, I can eat two or three at a time. Well, you might as well get the big flagel then. But the mini everything flagels there, toasted with cream cheese, kill me. Just kill me. Go ahead. Kill me. Oh, look, it's Al Gorbachev. One of the video editing wizards behind the scene. What's going on, Al? Let's see here. Frank, so do you have a supply of rudeness for Tuesdays then? A supply of rudeness? Oh, yeah. Yeah. So here's the concept for Rude Tuesday. Then I'll get back into your I'll go back in the chat and see what I can make up for. The concept for Rude Tuesday is this. Go live. I open up the lines. I open up the lines and you have, I don't know if it's going to be 10 or 15 seconds, but you can say a lot in 10 seconds. The whole point is the line is open. Call in with anything. You have 10 seconds to hook me. And at 10 seconds, it is, you have to understand the rule. At 10 seconds, there's not even a goodbye if I'm not hooked and if you haven't gotten to it. I can't give it to you. At 10 seconds, the line is cut, and I say something, and I don't know, it's just going to be a rude moving on, and you're just thrown away like trash. You have to be okay with the premise and just realize it's not personal. And I think people think I can't do it. They say, you're too nice, Frank. I can do it. I know I can do it. And I think that this could be a cherished tradition of ours, or it can be a complete disaster. It could be a complete disaster, but something tells me, Frank, you have to try it. You just have to at least try. Rude Tuesday. It wouldn't be every Tuesday. Just somebody gets that. The thing is, I'll actually start rooting for people to fail. I know me. I'll be like, click, waste my time. Just say something rude. Because some other people say, Frank, I was playing golf one time in Florida, and I actually did wrestle an alligator, and I killed it. See that? I killed an alligator. With my bare hands. You need less than 3 seconds to say that, and I'll go, all right. Start from the beginning. And then we would just, whatever. I need to know about it. But I think it's something we're gonna have to try. Let's see here. It's cathartic. Yeah. I think it might be. What about shower streams? Oh, that's only on Gilded. That's only on Gilded. I'm happy and extra gay, says Sentence to Beth. Well, the eclipse made everybody gay. And if you were gay, it made you straight. That's what happened yesterday. A flagel. Yes, you don't know what a flagel is, Nikki? It's a flat bagel. It's like 50% less bagel. It's flat. It's a flagel. So the people who make the mini flagels, they're like these tiny little flat discs of bagel. And, oh, so good. It's all the flavors that you love about a bagel, but half of the guilt. Let's see here. That's the one thing I do love about immigrants from the way down south. They make me feel like a super tall runaway model. Runway model. That's Katie. Probably talking about the short Mexicans. LA has shit bagels. Let me go up. Frank, how are you and your family? Says Sandra Evans. Fine. Aurora actually went out for a second round of grocery shopping with Lauren now, because I just go to the deli. Lauren goes to the grocery store. And Aurora's doing all right. Jenster's Upper Crust Bagels. I think there was an Upper Crust Bagel in Rye, New York. That's been gone for years, though. That's been gone for years. Let's see here. What am I listening to? I put a Pandora, what is it, Weary Eyes Radio. It was like a stick figure radio station. I put it through my Sonos over here. Let me see. Let's go to Chillwave Radio. I can always just put on the quite frankly. Oh, nice. Rapture at Sea. I remember listening to this song. Listen to this. I have very distinct memories of this song. Eastern Sun, Rapture at Sea. In 2005, I had just gotten Sirius Satellite Radio. I had the receiver and everything, and I hooked it up and I spliced it into my my bedroom television. Oh, it was a big hulking bedroom television. I saved up for that one too. It had a DVD player and a VCR. And I was able to work this into it so that when I logged into, I think it was PlayStation 2 at the time, it was the first one that I had a modem attached to. Might have been 2 or 3. It might be 2. 2005. Anyway, I was playing MLB 2005. Manny Ramirez on the front cover. And it's the first game I ever played multiplayer, sports game I ever played multiplayer. Between that and SOCOM. And I was in college. I just remember nights putting on the kind of the electronica station, the electronic music station on Sirius XM. This song was played a lot back then, and I really loved it. And I listened to this. This was coming out of one speaker on the television, and the game audio was coming out of the other speaker. And I'd just be sitting there playing baseball and listening to this until 2-3 o'clock in the morning. And I have a lot of memories attached to specific songs, like you guys do too. That's mine for Rapture at Sea. All right. Let's see. I'm off to do my extra gay shower stream. Okay. Have a good one, Beth. Let's see what else we have. Just a couple more minutes. What we did, 26 minutes? I just wanted to get at least a half hour in because then I'm going to go write, put my notes together for the show tonight. And who knows? If the guys say, let me see. Hey, fellas, we getting together tonight? Just want to know, so I know how to write the show. Let's see what they say. If somebody has a problem and they can't come tonight, I think we might do Rude Tuesday. I think we might just do a pilot test tonight. See if Derek and Tom and Anthony respond to me in a timely fashion. See here. No practice tonight because the band is blind. Oh yeah. Yes. Yes. I actually am blind right now. All right, couple more minutes. Throw whatever you got at me. Anything you got at me, any kind of topics you'd like to do on the show. I've got a growing list of things that I want to develop. We're going to save 6 degrees of separation, I think, is going to be next Monday, the 15th. I think the 15th, we're going to be doing 6 degrees of separation. So that'll be fun. There's already a lot of people that have put entries into that. All the famous people that they're related to and throughout history, that is pinned to the top of the forum on quitefrankly.tv. Check that out. Astrological forecast for the future. What was the name of the dairy again? Meadow Ridge Farm. It's called myrealfoods.com. Grass-fed meats and dairy delivered to New York, Connecticut, Massachusetts, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Maryland, Virginia, Rhode Island, and West Virginia. Meadow Ridge Farm. That's where I get my goat kefir. That's where I get my eggs. I buy 5 dozen eggs at a time since it's every 2 weeks delivery. Then again, if I have 8 eggs a morning, you can see why I would need at least five dozen at a time. But they're great. They're fertilized, no soy, no grain. And unwashed. So, and they're only $8 a carton, which, you know, if you're buying high quality eggs anyway, 8 is about average, if not a little bit lower. Let's see here. Sour Patch Kids or Skittles? I like, you know what it is? I like the sour, I like the sourness of the Sour Patch Kids, but I like the chewiness of the Skittle. I don't like the Sour Patch Kid. I don't like actually chewing it afterwards. It's not like a, it's not the type of gummy that I really like. It's the type of gummy that sticks to your teeth. So let's see. Pop Tarts or Twinkies? Maybe a Twinkie. They're both bad, so you're not making any choices based on what's good for you. Maybe the Twinkie, but it has to be, I have to have some milk with it though. Milk has to be. I like dunking a Twinkie in milk. I haven't done that in a long, long time, years. I haven't had a Twinkie in at least 15 years. I haven't had a Devil Dog in at least 15 years. I used to love Devil Dogs. They make sour Skittles. Well, then we might be onto something. Skittles are poison, so there's that. Strudels. Strudel. Strudel. There's a great pastry and coffee shop called Patisserie. Patisserie. A couple towns over. And the woman that works there, she was, we got friendly. And I said, "What is this? What is this? An apple turnover?" She goes, "It is strudel." I said, "Okay, I'll have one of the strudels." What's going on, Star Karma? Good to see Star. Hey, Katie, Rosie, Rev, and Freebie. What's going on, Cajun? Got friendly. Yeah, not friendly like that. Not friendly like that. There's too many people around. German pancakes are so good and easy. Betty's Eddies. I like saltwater taffy. Have you tried to get Dave Smith on the show? What does Dave Smith do, Jack? Oreos dunked until they're falling apart. Yeah, I can just throw or you know what I used to love to do? I used to love to take a maybe three or four chocolate croissants. I almost bought one today when I brought Aurora to the bakery, but I got her just a regular croissant. And I also let her pick out three mini black and white cookies that just came out of the oven over there. Dave Smith, you know what? I might follow him on Twitter. I think I might follow him on Twitter. I think I follow him on Twitter now that you bring it up. Nice. I love when Rufus Du Sol pops up. Especially this. This is the first song I ever heard of Rufus Du Sol, Two Clocks. I love jamming to it too. Ah. Keep throwing it my way. Doing well, Hadid. Doing well. Spending a little bit extra time doing the stream right now, just because we've got. Hold on. Hold on, Derek got back to me. You guys are gonna be here for the. Here is our, whatchamacallit, our verdict of whether or not we're going to have a 2-hour show or a 1-hour show tonight. You ready?
Hey fellas, we getting together tonight? Just want to know, so I know how to write the show.
Perfect timing. I was going to hit you up in a few minutes. I'm probably not making it because I still haven't even gotten out of Canada. Court and I came up to Canada for the
Canada? How'd you end up in Canada? Nobody's allowed in Canada. Canadians aren't even allowed in Canada. Holy shit. Well, it looks like we have a 2-hour show. Which means I have to get off now. I have to find some extra material. So, maybe we'll just do an hour and a half show. Just so I don't go too crazy. I was dead set on an hour. It's just really, it's a matter of how many people call in. I mean, we can talk for forever. But just, you know, call in. There'll be that. Do we do Rude Tuesday? I don't know. You can't, Rude Tuesday seems like you can't do for 2 hours. It's got to be an hour long hit on a band practice night when you had just a little bit of time to do something fun. Rude Tuesday. We can't be rude for 2 hours. So, can't. No, Nikki. Extend Rude Tuesday. You can't do it for 2 hours. I don't think so. Maybe we can. But we'll see. That's that. All right, guys. I guess I'll see you all soon. If you want, you can just jump into the Gilded. There's a lot of people hanging out there, chatting throughout the day. What if someone with a good story calls in and we get no rudeness? Rude Tuesday is not about calling in and just being shit on. It's just that I'm going to be rude if you don't get to the point quick. So you have to call in. You have 10 seconds to spit out the hook. You can do that in less than 5 seconds. And it's either, it's not interesting. Just not interesting. Frank, I prepared my taxes yesterday. I got a big refund. Don't care. Stop wasting my time. Click. But if it, like I said, you call in, Frank, 2 years ago, I saved my brother from an alligator attack. We were playing golf in Florida, and I choked the alligator out. It's dead. I want to talk to that person for a few minutes, and you stay on with me. So it's not just that you're calling in to get shit on. It's just that you got to represent your interests. Very good. Frank's so poor, he can't pay attention. Pay attention to who? Have you ever watched the chat room when a caller can't get to the point? Okay, I'm trying to save people. You have no clue what my job is like. People really just don't understand what my job is like. I am actually in the business of saving people from the internet. I so desperately am there trying to make every call a home run for the caller so that they'll call in again. You know? You know? I'm so desperately trying to save people. I want it to be a success for them, because do not look at the chat room. Don't look at them. You can't. When a caller wins over the chat room, that is, I feel proud for them. I'm happy for them. You know, I go that night, you know, when I sign off, I sit back and go, oh, I feel bad. I feel good for that guy. Feel good for that woman. Oh, I'm so glad that the audience liked that. I like that they jived. Because I bring people together. I like bringing people together and having, you know, introducing people. Okay, now you guys go be friends. I like doing that. I don't want to, I'm not one for public crucifixions. So, anyway. All right, I got a little bit of work to do, guys. We'll see what happens tonight. Lynn Morello says, my accent's too thin. Just call in. Just call in. Just do it. All right, we'll see what happens tonight. Yankees are fun to watch so far. Yeah. It would have been a great show to be at, game to be at last night. A little topper. Would have been a great show to be at last night. I spent $444 so that four seats in section 227B, row 13, seat 1 through 4, can just, I don't know, maybe a squatter moved in. Maybe a squatter moved in to the four seats last night. They brought some homeless guy in from the streets. Hey, we got four open. It would have been a great game to be at. Home run Volpe, home run Soto. Verdugo had a nice night. Son of a bitch. Okay, good night, everybody. Well, I'll see you tonight. Be good. Where's my mug? My mug is right up there. My mug. Right next to the Zoso dude mug. And all the mommy mugs. There's one of Lauren's mommy mugs right next to Aurora's. Oh, I love that little mug. Aurora sits down. I'll get off right after this story. She'll, we'll hang out at the table over here, and I'll sit down, and I'll have a coffee or something, and she'll say, "Dad, can I have a coffee with you?" So what I'll do is I'll get her these. We got these little, whatchamacallit, these little cappuccino mugs or whatever the hell they're called. Anyway, I'll give her this mug. She wants some coffee, so I give her a little bit of cream, a little bit of half and half. So she'll be sitting there with this. I'll be sitting with my mug right there. And she gets the social cues. I put a little half and half in there, and she'll hold it like this, and I'll sit there with my mug, and she'll go, "So, how's your day going?" I love it. She has the, "So, how's your day going?" Oh. I looked at her, I said, "You are going to be one cool chick to hang out with, girl. You already are." I can't even imagine the great conversations we're going to have. So, how's your day going? That's that. All right, I'll see you guys tonight. Get into the Gilded or email me if you have any ideas or thoughts. And that's that. Maybe we'll all go to a Yankee game soon. We need a Coffee with Aurora show. Yeah, I'll trust me. There'll be some Aurora shows. That's that. Until later. Be good.